Hi y'all, it's Lori on LouLouShive, and I'm here today to show you another mini that I created. And this mini uses colors that I normally do not use. I was shopping to create a mini to put pictures from the summer, from swimming in the pool and different birthday events that I went to, and I didn't want to use just a normal color, so I purchased at Michael's the Carolyn Gavin paper line, and it's very bright. Lots of bright pinks, neon greens. I'll kind of flash through it in case you haven't seen it, but it's very different from my style, from the colors that I normally use, so this was a challenge for me to see how to use this. I do like it to create cards now with the leftovers, so you'll see how I kind of blended the colors together and created. It seemed like everything went together on the pages. But I actually purchased the border stickers also, and that's what these two are. And I did use pop dots for flowers on the border to bring it up. Lots of pop dots on the front with a prima flower and a brad. And also used a lot of different colored ribbons, oranges, greens, blues, pinks. And when you open it up, you'll see that the paper is very bright, very busy. On this page, I have a tag where I cut out pieces of the paper and pop them up. And on the inside, I create some flourishes and journaling lines. And I love this stamp. I love the elementary look of it, the paper you used in elementary school to practice your ABCs. I like that journaling stamp. I use it a lot. And this is the back plane for photos. But you can see the paper's very busy, lots of different colors, browns and pinks and greens all on one line, all on one page. And actually lots of glitter. And then on the second page, I create a pocket from the paper. I cut it out and I did a simple tag. I actually put the photo and the journaling here so you could journal a little bit about the picture that you put on the front, and it has a sticker. And then this is part of the embellishment pack on the back. It had a brad, a flower brad. And then up at the top for the pull for the tag, I just glued two, I guess that would be flowers together. And this is the circle, scallop. And on the next page, you'll see the colors are really bright. This is a journaling spot with some flowers, and I actually cut this from my Cricut. And you can put, it's functional, you can put something behind it. On this page, I created a pocket to hold my tag. And the tag it has a flower, and I think this is supposed to be a tree. I'm not quite sure, but I thought it looked great for a pool for the tag. So on the back, I have the border at the top with a sticker from the paper line and two journaling spots. And I don't know if you can see it, but this is actually part of a top note that I created on both sides as a border to the top of the tag. On this page, this is a border again, one of the border stickers, and a sticker that came with the line. And I chose to put little stickers here on the heart paper just to kind of bring out something different on the page. And I like the paper. It seems like I just could put a little bit, embellish the page at the bottom and able to put photos. And this is the tag. I kind of kept it simple. Just did a border at the top with a little sticker here and a little sticker here, a little flower sticker. And on the back, two journaling spots with a border up at the top. This is another scallop circle with green apples, so it kind of blends in with the paper. And this is, I used this in one of my other minis, the first mini I ever made, and it's the circle card, and I love the way this is functional and how you can have more journaling spots and photo mats, but I'll show you the inside. I used the paper line and did a green on the inside. And then I created these little photo mats and journaling spots to put in the inside. And just, this one's just, the paper's so cute, you could just add it, cut it out and use it. I actually used an apple, which was part of the journaling spot. So the next page, let's see. This is part of the borders that I purchased, and I just glued it on both sides. This is one of the journaling spots also, and I just slid it down. And then on this page, this was a sticker, and I put it on two or three different pieces of the paper, kind of popped it up, brought out different colors on the page. And this is actually just some journaling spots and things I put on the page, in case I wanted to write about whatever picture I put here. And then on this page, this is again some of the borders, and I just tag them, I glue them on the sides. And on this, I create a little picture photo mat. So that's an orange brad with one of the orange flowers, and I glued a flower and did some embellishments on the side here. So, and then on the back, actually has some more journaling. So there's three here. Let me try to get them all where you can see. And then on this page, it's similar to this page. I try to get the colors to blend on the pages. So these are actually little chickens, and it's a chicken border with a butterfly border. And I did the same thing here. I created just a photo mat with a brad, and just had various pieces of the paper line attached on the inside, and there's journaling spots on the back. I tried to keep this plain in order to put a picture, and then on the back where it was busy, I put the photo mats, because I liked, once I started working with the paper, I really liked it. So on this page, this is just a top note cut out from, I believe, my Cricut, and a journaling spot. And this is a tag with a functional frame. You could slide a picture down in it. And on this page, it's just a like a ticket pocket. It has the ticket corners on it, and it has various tickets as well as a top note on the inside. I created a lot of things I could put pictures on, because I have a lot of pictures that I want to put in here, and I can slide them in and make notes. And on the back, this is just the back, and this is where I'll write down that I created the mini. So that's this mini.